There are many times when the carriage isn't going to deliver a big enough stitch size, and in those instances, instead of using the stitch dial to change stitch size, I'll manually reproduce much larger stitches. So in this case, for say Chinese knot stitch, I'm going to hold everything except the first bridge on the carriage side. My carriage is set to hold needles in holding position. And I'm going to knit one row across the bridge, hold those needles, and then while I'm here, I'm going to hand knit the next four needles all the way back against the rail. And you'll notice that I'm holding the previous needle as I knit the next one so that the needles can't creep forward. I'll back up the carriage, and then I'm going to knit the next four needles, return them to upper work position, knit them with stitch size 7 and hold them, and then manually knit the next four needles. Now, I usually try to leave these hand knit needles back in non-working position because that really becomes a holding position. But if you find that they're creeping forward and giving you problems, then you could just instead bring those needles right out to holding position and keep them at the front. So here's the last group. I'm going to do three of these Chinese knot stitches for you. So I'm going to move some of these stitches back so that you can actually see what I'm doing here. Normally I wouldn't bother doing this because they're really not in my way, but I think they're in the way of the camera. So I'm going to work on these first four large stitches first. And I'm going to remove the first two stitches on a two-prong transfer tool. And I'm going to insert my latch tool behind and then in front of that first pair of stitches to grab the third stitch and pull it through. I'll deposit that stitch on the first needle. And then I'm going to pass the tool in front and then behind, the opposite of what I did the first time. And deposit that stitch on the second needle. And then I'm going to replace the third and fourth stitches, or the first and second stitches on the third and fourth needles. So here we go again. I'm going to remove two stitches, pass the tool behind and in front, and then pull that first stitch, that third stitch through and put it on the first needle, and then grab the fourth stitch, pull it through and place it on the second needle, and then once again, move the first and second stitches to the third and fourth needles. So they've changed positions much the way they do when you cross cables, except these stitches weave through each other rather than crossing.